Morning. It's 8 minutes past five, bit up since 4:30. I'm at Watford Junction because there are some mornings when you wake up and you think, I wonder how long it would take me to get around all 112 London Overground stations. So we're doing it.
My plan route for the day is to start at Watford, come down into Euston, cross London, over to Battersea and Clapham, knock out the Richmond and Shepherd's Bush branches, go over the top of the North London Line, down the East London Line and do Clapham, Crystal Palace and West Croydon, not forgetting New Cross on the way back up to Liverpool Street, where I've then got to do the three branches out to Enfield, Chesham and Chingford, then nip out east to ride between Romford and Upminster to do Emerson Park, and then finish by riding the whole of the Gospel Oak to Barking Line in one go, starting at Barking and finishing at Upper Holloway.
Watford High Street.
The train.
This is the train to Euston.
It is heading for Euston to tick off the Watford branch, going to a very awkward station to get it out of the way early.
Next station, Headstone Lane.
Easily the Overground's most awkward station due to its limited service.
Alright, onto the southern train. That'll take me one stop to Battersea Park. And this Overground train here is a man smiling a little smug smile because I'm just relieved and very happy to have made it because it's the most awkward one to catch. Can you see here, between Wandsworth Road and Clapham Junction, it's not on the map. If you also look on a standard tube map, Battersea Park is not shown because it gets a limited service.
Yeah, so Battersea Park is a valid London Overground station. It's just really awkwardly served. And that is why I started at Watford Junction this morning at 5:13.
So I've got a 15-minute wait here at Wandsworth Road. I'm going to go to Clapham and then get a train to Richmond and pick up the Richmond branch. Richmond, 11 minutes past 7. That gave me 10 minutes to get some breakfast and a cup of tea over to platform 4. So we'll get this one and go up to Willesden Junction and change there. And there's a tiny bit of light in the sky. The sun should be rising hopefully in the next 20 to 30 minutes. Hilton Junction. Oh, there's a train leaving. Where's that going? Annoyingly, I think that was a Clapham train, which means I'll have to wait for the next one. But whilst I wait, there's an amazing sunrise, so it's not all bad. It's 8:05. The sun has risen. I'm at Imperial Wharf. I'm reversing. It's weird because you have to exit the gate line here, tap out, and then re-tap in to change platforms. There's a separate gate line for each platform. I'm going to head back north through Willesden Junction again on a train towards Stratford. I was at Wandsworth Road this morning. What I'm going to do is come down through Peckham and Denmark Hill. If I get out of Wandsworth Road, that's no good. If I go to Clapham, that would get me a train to West Croydon. But what's probably quicker is if I get out of Clapham High Street, dash across the road to Clapham North, underground, go a couple of stops down to Balham, pick up National Rail there, and come down into West Croydon from Balham. That will probably, I hope, will be quicker than going to going back to Clapham. So it's 10:40, I made it to West Croydon, I'm really tired, and I'm starting to think, what am I doing this? 6 hours, I've just counted Crystal Palace, 61 stations. So I'm averaging about 10 stations an hour. So at 112 stations, that's going to take 11 hours. It's a familiar face.
I bought you some orange lime treats.
And to match your orange juice. Oranges, yeah.
And some Reese's.
Which is because it's orange. I'm at Liverpool Street. I need to do the Enfield Town, the Chingfield. Chingfield? Yeah, that's right, Geoff. I'm so tired. Don't ever do this on the 5:13. You do not need 313 bus from Chingford to Southbury. Don't ever do this. This is exhausting. So the voice has gone. My voice has really gone. Made it to Southbury. It's just gone 1 o'clock. That means I've been going for 8 hours. 8 hours. I thought I was going to finish this in 9. I'm not. It's going to be at least 10, and it might even be 11. Go up to Chessington and back. Jump over to the Enfield Town branch. Knock out the two by Hackney, get over to Emerson Park and then come back and finish on the Gospel Oak Barking Line. It might even be 12 hours. Yeah. This is not a fast time. Made it to Chesant. It's the 13:31. Back out again. Okay, to the bus stop. My bus upstairs. I'm at Crown Road. There's a 121 in 1 minute. But the train leaves from Enfield Town in 9 minutes. London Fields, followed by Cambridge Heath, then changing from Hackney Downs to Hackney Central by walking along a relatively new interchange corridor. Then this train to take me to Stratford, where I then get onto a purple train, which was really busy until everybody, almost everybody, got out at Ilford. But that brings me here to Romford, where I change onto this overground train so that I can go and tick off Emerson Park. Thanks.
This train is for Upminster.
And so, at Upminster, we just get the tube down to Barking and on to the Gospel Oak and Barking line for the last train. The last train. And I'll finish at Upper Holloway. It's now 4:45. It's been an exceedingly long day. It's been over 11 hours and I'm at Upper Holloway London Overground Station, which is the last of all 112 overground stations. However, a twist in the tale. Somehow I missed the fact that all day the Gospel Oak to Barking line has been out of action. A freight train derailed at 6 a.m. this morning, and upon getting to Barking earlier from Upminster, there were no trains, nothing at all.
Apparently something was running between South Tottenham and Gospel Oak earlier, I asked, but I've got here via DLR and a bus from Caledonian Road and Barnsbury. And so I think my tally is 102 out of 112. I looked though on Journey Planner, what should have happened is that when I got to Barking, I should have been in time to get the 15:48, and that would have got me here at 16:11, which means if I started at 5:13 this morning, I think that's my total time would have been 11 hours and 4 minutes, which still isn't even very good. I think on the leaderboard, where only like 7 people have been recorded, I come 8th. So I didn't even get like 9 or 10 hours. I was just over 11 hours. So just over 11 hours, and failed to complete by missing out these stations because the Gospel Oak to Barking line isn't running. I'm just going to have to laugh about it, because otherwise I'll just cry. I cannot tell you how tired I am and how exhausted I am and how I've got to the end and foiled at the end. But sometimes that's just what happens. I got nothing.